Hey, so you got your blog up and running on Wix, you got all the layout ready to go, and now it's time to actually put some content on there. So I'm gonna walk you through a screen-by-screen, play-by-play tutorial right here on the Six Figure Mastermind. Keep watching. All right, so it's time to write your post on your Wix blog. I love using Wix. I love just to take a Sunday afternoon or a Monday morning or whenever I have 15 to 20 minutes that are free and just put some content out there. What I love about using Wix is that you can, if you like take a few hours and you have a bunch of content that you want to put together, you can just create scheduled posts. So if let's say if you write 7 days worth of blog posts, you can have those pushed out over the course of the next 7 days by scheduling them. I love it. So let's just walk through really quickly, and I'm going to show you on my screen right here how to get through Wix and how to write a blog post. Okay, so I'm logged in right here on my Wix account. Again, go to www.wix.com. You've already got your setup. What you'll need to do is go to your sites. Okay, I'm going to go to this site right here, and I'm going to say, okay, I need to add some content to this site. I need to add a blog post. So it's going to open up to my sites tab right over here, and I can say manage and edit site. Once I click on that, it's going to open up this screen that you saw just a minute ago. So this is how you got here, all right? So what I need to do is click edit site. Now, this isn't necessarily going to make all these different kinds of changes, but I am going to be able to write another blog post. It's going to take me to a page where I can edit everything in my site, from the banner, to the logo, to the menus, to the buttons, every gadget and doodad that you have going on your site. But all I need to do is create a blog post. So I'm going to hover over here to these buttons. This is my home base here, and I'm going to click on My Blog. What do you need to do? We need to add a blog post. So once I click on that, it's going to take us over to the page where we manage all of our blog posts. Now, again, it's easier to do on a desktop than it is on the mobile device, although it can be done in both places. I prefer to do it on a desktop if I, you know, want to make a lot of changes and move things around and add pieces and HTML and all of that. It's just easier. But you also, if you just want to put some content out there and you want to do it on your app, we've created another video for you to walk you through how to do that on your mobile device. So first things first, I need to create an engaging title. I'm going to say top 10, except you're going to spell 10 right, things you need to know when traveling internationally. Now, I do a lot of speaking gigs internationally. I travel probably 4 times a year overseas, so it's really, you know, a very cool thing for a six-figure community to know. Say author name, I'm just going to put myself on there. Sometimes I have other contributing authors that help me out with this. If you do have other contributing authors for your blog, that's totally cool. Just make sure they're giving themselves credit. Okay, and then I'm going to start writing my post here, and I'm just going to fill this in with random stuff. And then I'm going to create a new line right here with a divider. Put that in there, and then I'm gonna say, okay, I'm gonna go bold, say Control B, bold language, and then I'm gonna go number 1. Okay, so how do I do my numbering system? I'm saying it's the top 10 things here. I'm just gonna do it like I normally would at home. So I'm gonna take the bold off and put in number 1. This is what you need to know. Number 2, this is what you need to know. Number 3, this is what you need to know, okay? And I can even take all of these and create little subheadings. So maybe I want to take this and I want to make it, you know, italicized and, you know, maybe put an underline on it. Maybe I want to make it a link to a store I want to buy. Top 10 things you need to know is you need to buy this thing. I can put this link to my Amazon affiliate if I want, or if I can just put it to someone else's affiliate, wherever I got the product, I would link it there. If you are going to do affiliates, make sure that you're putting on your website that you do have an affiliate link and that you do get a thank you check from wherever you're getting that affiliate. It's just good business to do that. You can change the colors here. You can change the justification, left, right, center alignment. You can change the size here. You can change your default settings here, whatever you want your body of your paragraph to look like. Okay, I usually just leave it alone. Leave it cohesive for all your posts. I don't really need that italicized and underlined, so I'm going to take those off. Okay, what's so cool about doing this on the desktop is you can add video. Let's say if you have a YouTube channel, you want to put your video in there. You can totally click video and put the video in there. You can put that directly from your YouTube link, okay? You can do video search and add other videos. It's totally great. You can also get rid of that. Add a gallery of images if you want. Add a single image if you want. What I like about Wix is you can upload a bunch of different images directly from your phone to your Wix sites. All of these that I've already uploaded, they're available to me. So I can just go ahead and upload those. Or I can use stuff that's been posted on other posts. I can also use social images. It'll connect to my face. This is so cool, you guys. It connects to my Facebook, Instagram, Dropbox, Google Drive, Flickr, and Google Photos all automatically. This is going to save you so much time, okay? It's also going to give you free images directly from Wix. So if you're cool using stock footage, they have that available. Also from Shutterstock, you can purchase images using Shutterstock if that's something that you want to have on your site, okay? Now for a blog post, I don't think that's really necessary, but you can use it if you like it. Okay, so here's the cool part. You can save this as a draft, you can publish the post, or you can click this little downward arrow and say schedule post. So if I just hammer out a bunch of content in one day and say I want to publish once a week, I can hit that scheduled post feature and I can tell it when to schedule those posts for. Before I publish, I can preview it. I always, always, always recommend doing that. You can make it a featured post, which means it's going to bump it up to the top of your page. Also, add tags. If there's something that's, and the reason we want to add tags is to make it easily searchable on Google. So a top 10 things you need to know about traveling, I would tag travel. I would tag travel for business. I would tag helpful hints, lots of different tags to put in here. You can also, if you also have a related post already up on your blog, you can have the related post be shown at the end of this blog post to kind of drive readership to your blog, have people stay on your site a little bit longer, okay? So when we do that, we're gonna either click publish or click post. You know, this is really cool. I accidentally clicked off this post, but Wix was like, hey, Marianne, I got your back. We're gonna save this for you. So it saved it automatically as a draft. Now, if you watch our other videos, you'll see that I created a couple extra drafts on my phone just in those videos, and it's already saved them as mobile drafts right here. Thank you, Wix. You got our back. That's awesome. Okay, so this is what is available here, and when you're ready to post it, all you need to do is click post. You're going to be able to see it on your website, up for everyone to see, share it on social media platforms, let everyone give you some comments and some feedback on your post. And you know, it's going to give you some really great statistics when you do that. It's going to track all that information for you, see what people are liking, see what people want more of, see what people don't want to see. Using Wix is a great platform for design and for pushing your content out there in a really beautiful way. Okay, get those posts out there. Sometimes that can be the scariest thing. Just push that aside. Get your content out there for the world to see. Hit the subscribe button. I'll see you tomorrow.